Hello, world and SSG followers and YouTubers. So it is 2015. We are already here. So what have I here? I have here simple schoolgirl Bedini circuit wheel with magnets, etc., etc. This is my continuous research of what I can do with the following setup. On this side I have a charging battery. It is resting voltage 11.89 milliamps, actually 000, because I did not start the system yet. Look at another side. Primary battery the same, 12 volt 5 amp hour battery. This is the same type of chemistry and battery and manufactured as a charging battery. So 12 volt 5 amp hour each battery of the capacity. And here I have my primary battery with a full charge, 12.50. So as before I start my experiment, I say following. This battery, which you currently seeing, charging battery, it was previously 20 times charged and discharged by the Bedini. Probably proper to say I charge with the Bedini circuit and discharge with a different circuit. Discharge different circuit. So my experiment is what I'm expect to see from this experiment. I want to charge this battery by the impulses which produce my circuitry when each magnet passes the coil, and then I produce a lot of impulses, and then I save these impulses, the impulses going to the battery plates, and as a result my charging battery charging, and the rate of the charging of the battery is higher than with a conventional charging device. This is my claim. But anyway, let's start the procedure. You actually hearing self-oscillation noise. This is shouldn't happen. What I actually do, I disconnect one part of the circuitry from my primary battery and then reconnect, and now I can start the procedure. Move my wheel. Okay, so I actually move my wheel, and here you go, charging process started. You see, it's charging my battery with a small current, but in theory and the praxis I claim following. I do not charge the battery with the current because it's too small to charge the battery. I charge my battery with very short, rapid and powerful impulses. And if you're not sure what I mean, just look my previous videos from the last year and you will know then what I mean. So you see, actually charging process is not rapid, but it's very quality charge, because when my charging procedure ends, my charging battery reach a voltage level 12.15, and like that. So one important thing about all the circuitry, it's not another unity system. Why? Because I lose here energy but gain energy on this side. And there's always a question how much I lose the energy before I get my other battery to full capacity. So by any means, it's not another unity, it's not another unity system in the present state. But still I can charge my battery on the other side. So very interesting. And yeah, here you go, the values, voltage level as expected decrease because I'm doing some work with my circuitry. I'm spending 30 milliamps, I will say, rough. And the idea which I'm currently have in my head. The idea is following. I will charge my battery. This secondary battery, which I'm currently charging, I will charge this battery to the full capacity. Then I disconnect all of my batteries. Then I connect to my charged battery inverter. To the inverter I connect a conventional charging device, and I will actually try to charge the primary battery from the secondary battery, but it will happen in the different setup, so expected to see some interesting stuff. And this is ongoing research. Anyway, I'm babbling through, and I just will, And I have good news. I'm actually putting my resources, small resources, but I will be able to upgrade my setup with additional coil, which I will put like on the top. And then it will be interesting construction, because I need to build two additional wooden plates to hold this coil at the top, and this will be second coil, which I can say it will be my generator coil. It will be like four windings. The windings will be, now I'm trying to describe how I will wind my coil. Let me say this. I will wind my coil with a Bedini method. So it will be four windings, but it will be done so that I will have only one cable. So all of my four windings will be connected, which each points. So just imagine, let me explain this. You see this green cable, yeah? Just imagine I have four green cables, and each end of the cable I will connect to the each point of the cable. So at the end result I will get only one wire. But this is actually not one wire, it's actually more than one wire. And then I will make from all of this wire a coil. This coil would be connected to the capacitor. It will be like a 400 volts capacitor. Then from this capacitor I will have load to discharge this capacitor, to discharge this capacitor to another same quality of capacitor. And this will be all on my primary side. So I will have not this battery, I will have two capacitors, one to collect the energy which I'm producing from the second coil, and then put this energy from the capacitor to the another capacitor, and then this capacitor will be discharged by the voltage divider. And I hope it will work or not work. I'm not sure yet, but this is actually my plans for the March 2015, to build two capacitors to change one 5 amp hour battery and drive the system to the madness. But this will be big huge step for me, because putting another coil produce interesting observation, which I hope to see. But in any case, what I'm actually currently trying to do, I want to charge my secondary battery to the full capacity, then disconnect all of my batteries, and then connect them, as I described earlier, an inverter to the charging battery, then from the inverter the conventional charging device, and then I will try to charge my primary battery, and when I get fully charged my primary battery with the other battery, I mean, which I previously charged by the Bedini, then I will do this again and again and again, and just to see how battery can be charged with this type of the procedure. And yeah, it will be interesting. And I will post some of my experiments on YouTube on my channel. Yeah, like that. So just to see some interesting neat stuff in the future. But anyway, charging process happens pretty damn good, I would say. So voltage, of course, it's not the all sign. This is not a sign that I'm actually doing something suitable, but it is observation which give me some signs where I'm going to. So I hope to get my secondary battery to the full charge, and when I achieve this result, I will disconnect the battery from the SSG circuitry, put the inverter to my charging battery, and then from the inverter I will put conventional charging device, and then I will charge my primary battery. So that I hope to achieve such results, but this will be interesting, and this will be as I described it earlier, but by any means current setup is not an over unity for me. If you want to know what is over unity for me, it's like, do have one energy source, then you doing some work and you produce an additional energy source, but then you should have such circuitry that will this circuitry which I am describing currently. I know it's only, like I say, in theory, but in theory, if you have one energy source and you produce through all of your work produce another additional energy source, then your circuitry should like I said earlier, contain the two energy sources. And this, I think this is a very huge and big problem, because it's too fast, it's very fast. So megahertz frequency. So it's very, 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 very fast, and to catch the all of things and all of impulses which you can actually can take, it's one of the big challenges. But for me, over unity, it means it doesn't matter what I'm doing with the circuitry. The circuitry should have enough power to contain itself. If you cannot show me with a measuring that you contain the energy, that you not lose the secondary energy source, then you should probably stop doing that. So it's not an over unity what I'm actually showing you. And many people trying some, I will say, strange stuff, but I'm not doing strange stuff. This is all still by the book, and as out of the patent Bedini itself described. So still I'm in safe zone. Yeah. So decrease of my voltage on primary. You're seeing that. So it's not free at all. It's you're spending actual milliamps to run the system, and at some point it stop working because your battery produce not enough energy. So this is one of the signs of this system. But you getting the charge another battery. So it's not like you're wasting all of your energy, and the wasting of the energy, and how you're wasting your energy is important too. Because with this time of the system, I will probably say it's very efficient. It's very efficient. And this is a simplified system to show people that you actually can charge the battery with a short, powerful, current-less impulses. So take like this. It's not another unity, but it produces these strange impulses. It is not an it's not a back EMF. It's larger than that, and I showed earlier on my oscilloscope. And if somebody have digital scope, you can send me over. Just message me at my YouTube channel. I will do experiment and gladly send your oscilloscope back. I do not need to prove anything to anybody. I just want to share my experiments. So the goal of my experiment, once again, to charge this battery from the Bedini circuitry to the full capacity, then disconnect all of circuitry, then put to the battery inverter, and then from the inverter connect to the inverter a conventional charging device, and then with this all connection charge the primary battery. So think about these things, and you shouldn't have any trouble. So for people who are actually interested in building this stuff, what can be done better? I don't know. Probably I would point you, look at my copper cable. This copper cable, it is the same material as in my coil. So all of connections should be done with the same material, because it's of a nature of the impulses which I'm getting. If I have different material connection, different cables connection, I'm losing some of the impulses. Maybe it's not essential, but I notice it. My overall performance has increased when I hook up with the same cable type as in my coil. So what additional things which you should notice? I'm using MGL transistor. Here is it, MGL transistor. And this transistor is more suitable for experiment. It produces much better impulses when you compare this to the additional to the standard transistor. So take this for information. And of course you need to have some type of this oscilloscope, because you need to observe the nature of the impulses which you're actually getting. So at the beginning of all of things, of the experiments, I didn't use oscilloscope, didn't know how to use it. But I think for people who actually starting right now building such system, they have more better experienced information, and they can gain more information and much quality information. So if you seeing this and want to build yourself, just go to the Energy Science forum from Aaron Murakami, the guy who created the forum about all of Bedini stuff. They are selling their books about how to build this type of system, and I am strongly advised for novice, for beginners, just to buy the book and build the system from the book. It cannot go wrong with these instructions. And what about coil? Coil, at some point I will say, it depends how fast you want to gain results. My first coil, I won't say this was built with a high efficiency in mind. It was just built to work. But if you want to build coil, maybe, probably, if you have more resources, just build larger coil. It's my coil currently 10 centimeters. I don't know how to measure in American standards. So sorry guys from US. But if you build coil, I'll say 20 centimeters and wind the coil counterclockwise, and the coil will work in an attraction mode, then you probably will get better results. One of the things which I'm always think it's difficult for beginners, it's to put the wheel at the suitable height. This is the things which you should probably do experimentally. And what I mean by that, if you have such construction holding type of the of your device construction, that you can actually move the wheel to different heights, then you actually want to have some oscilloscope to observe the impulses. And if you observe the impulses, then you can actually get even better results. The amount of magnets depends. It's like from 20 to from 15 to 20 magnets. But one of the most important stuff, I always forgot, that's battery. You need battery where you can actually absorb the electrolyte in the battery. Sorry guys. So you need to have such batteries where you can fill up the distilled water. If you cannot fill distilled water, and I saw that in many videos, this is actually bad batteries for this type of the experiment. And reason is very simple. With the sealed lead acid battery, they have water molecule too, but at some point it just quits, it's vaporized. So you don't have the water in your sealed lead acid battery, and good luck to bringing the battery of such type to the best performance. So just for starters, use lead acid batteries. The batteries where you can fill up the distilled water. And I'm bubbling through, but it's experimental type of system. Do not take this is a production type system. No, it's research and experimental system to observe the impulse charging. And I cannot tell if somebody have such production type system where you can put the system to the inverter and just run from that. It's not. But if you want to research this system to observe some things, it should probably done like this. And anyways, I should tell you I'm actually done with my video, and see you next. It's charging, pretty good charge level, and hope I will put a new video sooner than later. So thank you all for watching this. Bye bye.